I'm Jonathan Ayres with Networked for Success, and today we're going to talk about what is an iLink port. Most of us commonly know an iLink port as a firewire port, and these are ports that are on computers that are used to transmit data. In order to use this port, you have to have a cable. So right here in front of me, I have a computer that has an iLink port or firewire port, and I have a cable. And I'll just show you really quickly what that looks like. Here is exactly what the port looks like, and you'll notice that it has a rectangular shape, but at one end it has a little dome on it. So in order to use an iLink port, you do nothing more than plug the cable in, and then you on one end and plug it in on the other end, and you have a connection. Now, what are some of the nice things about iLink cables or firewire cables that we could show to make them worthwhile? Well, one issue is that they transmit data very, very quickly. So, for example, they'll transmit data at 400 kbps kilobytes per second or 800 kilobytes per second, which is very fast. So it makes it very convenient for video or other types of material that you're going to send over a wire that have a lot of data attached to them. The other nice thing about a FireWire or iLink setup is that it will power a device on the other end. So it will also be able to provide electricity, whereas this is not true of other types of setups. For example, USB does not automatically offer electricity coming down the wire, and you have to have a separate power supply for many USB setups. So our advantages for using an iLink or FireWire port are that it transfers data very, very quickly, and it provides an electrical connection.